Hello everyone. I'd like you to watch this video on long-term sources of financing, where I would be discussing about debt financing. This is our topic three in financial management. Let's first try to understand what is debt financing. Debt financing is where the borrower receives money in exchange for a promise to repay it at some future time. And therefore, we can say that debt is an obligation to repay. And the borrower is known as the debtor, and the lender is known as the creditor. Now, the amount of money which is borrowed is also referred to as the principal amount. And this amount is repaid either at the end of a specified period, or it may be even repaid at regular intervals during the entire period of the debt. The lender receives an interest in return for lending his funds, and this interest may be repaid, or sorry, it may be paid periodically, which is every 6 months or every year, which is annual repayment of interest. While for some other types of debt, the interest may be also be paid at the end of the maturity period or the specified period. Now let's look at what does bond mean further. A bond, a firm may borrow money by issuing bonds. Therefore, bonds are also a kind of debt which usually the corporations issue in order to borrow money. A bond is essentially a long-term contract under which a borrower agrees to make the payments of interest and principal on specified dates to the holder of the bond. Who is known as the bondholder, who is also the lender. For example, on January 1, 2012, Tasty Food Products Company borrowed, say, $50 million by issuing 50 million bonds. So Tasty Food Products Company will receive the $50 million, and in exchange, it promises to make annual interest payments as well as to repay the $50 million on a specified maturity date. Now, in addition to that, what you should know is that the borrower, that is the corporation, pays the principal amount and the interest. And the bondholder is also known as the investor. The interest is paid on specific dates, which is also known as coupon payments. So this is something important that you should know. So the fixed amount of interest which is paid on bonds each year is called coupon. Apart from this, some additional information that you should know is that the corporation which issues the bonds, they show the bonds on the liability side of their balance sheet. Also, you should be aware that a bondholder, who is the lender or the investor, are not considered as the owners of the company. Further, the principal amount of the bond is repaid on maturity, and a bond has an indenture agreement. An indenture agreement spells out the rights and duties of the borrower, and hence it is considered as a legal agreement between the corporation which issues the bonds and the bondholders. So you, as you can see here, an indenture agreement will specify the rights and duties of the borrower. It also gives a description of the bond, which may be the interest, what is the amount of the interest payments, what will be the date on which the interest will be paid, as well as the date on which the principal amount will be paid, and the denomination of the bond payments. An indenture agreement will also mention the remedies, that is the solutions, in case the borrower fails to pay either the interest amount or the principal amount on maturity. The indenture agreement also specifies that it is the duty of the borrower, that is the corporation, to keep the bondholder informed about the financial conditions of the corporation. Apart from this, an indenture agreement may also have some other terms and conditions which are specified. For example, as you can see here, and this is called, if any such terms and conditions are mentioned, they are called restrictive covenants. Restrictive covenants. For example, restriction on payment of dividend. This means that the bondholder may impose some restriction on the corporation if the corporation, the financial condition of the corporation is not sound. Then the bondholder may try to protect itself from any risk of non-payment by imposing a restriction on the bondholder that it cannot pay any dividend to its shareholders from the profits until the corporation is able to make the payment on the bonds to the bondholder. So any such terms and conditions which is mentioned in the indenture agreement is known as a restrictive covenant. Now let's look at some basic features and provisions of a bond issue. We begin with the value of the bond, and about the value of the bond, a bond has a par value, which is also known as the face value. Further, a bond, the par value or the face value is also known as the nominal value. Let me bring in an example here. We generally assume that the par value of a bond is, say, $1,000, or it can be any multiples of 1,000. And the par value generally represents the amount of money that the firm borrows against the issue of a bond and promises to repay it on the maturity date. So you can also say that the par value of the bond is the same as the principal amount of the debt or the bond. And then you have the interest, which is also known as the coupon rate. And again, say for example, the Tasty Food Products Company bonds require the company to pay a fixed number of interest in dollar amount. Again, I'll bring in an example here. The Tasty Food Products Company bonds have a par value of $1,000 and maybe an interest of 10%. So if the interest is 10%, to calculate the dollar value of interest, you will multiply the par value, which is $1,000, with 10%, which is 0.10, and the amount that you get is $100. So $100 is the interest amount. And the payment, this is the payment which is fixed at the time the bond is issued, that is the coupon interest payment. The coupon rate remains fixed during the entire life of the bond. So the important point to remember here is that the coupon rate of interest does not change. It remains the same. And then a bond also carries a maturity date. That is, all bonds generally have a specified maturity date on which the par value or the face value of the bond has to be repaid. Example, Tasty Food Products Company bonds were issued on, say, January 1, 2012, and it will mature on January 1, 2027. So the maturity period is, say, 15 years. And then we come to the next feature, which is security. A bond may either be secured or it may be unsecured. If the bond is secured against a specific property of the issuer of the bond, that is the corporation, then such a security is called as a collateral. Now, the thing that you need to understand is why a company, a corporation may need to have a collateral, that is a property which is secured against the bond. This is in case the corporation does not pay either the interest amount or the it is unable to pay the face value of the bond on maturity, then securing the debt against a property that is a collateral gives an additional protection to the bondholder, where the bondholder can sell this property, which the corporation has put as a collateral, and the bondholder can recover their money from the sale of this security. And a debt which is not secured by any property is known as, generally known as a debenture. The next important feature which needs understanding is convertibility. That is, a bond may come with a conversion feature whereby the bondholder or the investor is given the right to exchange his bonds with, say, a common stock at the end of a specified period and at a predetermined price. That is that feature is known as convertibility, and in that case, such a bond will be known as a convertible bond. Now, let us look at the different types of bonds. There are basically two types of bonds. The first one is a government bond, and generally, if the government bond is issued by the US, it is also known as a treasury bond. Treasury bonds are issued by the federal government, which is the central government, and these bonds have no default risk, which means that because it is expected that the federal government will always make its promised payment and it will not default on the payment, therefore there is very little risk of non-payment in case of government bonds. Hence, it is known as a bond with no default risk. Now, contrast to the bonds issued by government, we also have corporate bonds. Corporate bonds are issued by corporations, that is private corporations, and there is a default risk in corporate bonds, and this risk is also known as credit risk. Therefore, we can say that corporate bonds are exposed to a default risk. If the issuing company gets into trouble, it may be unable to make the promised interest and principal payments. Now, when we say that if the issuing company gets into trouble, we mean that it may happen that the corporation which is issuing bonds may be making losses, and so it does not have enough funds to pay the interest amount or the principal amount of the bond, and so therefore that is a credit risk which is there in any corporate bond. And different bonds have different levels of default risk depending upon the issuing company's characteristics. So if a company is more risky, then the bonds issued by that company carries a high default risk, and a company which is has a very good reputation, then the bonds issued by that company will carry minimum credit risk. So therefore, the risk level depends upon the company characteristics. Other than this, you will see in the PowerPoint that there are some other types of bonds. which is only for your information. It is outside the scope of our